Tyler Craves Sonic.
From the station that's on your side, News 12, first at 5, continues.
Next, live at 5, Georgia lawmakers want to raise teacher pay. Stick around to hear how.
But first, a former teacher's aide arrested, accused of child molestation in a foot-licking incident. Now the guardian who made the report is speaking out.
The pattern of predators, they find the way, they will revolve their whole life around their fantasy.
Chilling words for any parent to hear.
Absolutely. And tonight we are learning more about what happened that day. Our Taylor Martin is live at Glen Hills Elementary School, where the suspect used to work.
This happened at the Urban Air Adventure Park over near Target on Robert C. Daniel, and they tell us the man who did it was there by himself. Corey Rollins is the man arrested for licking the toes of a 7-year-old boy. He's also a former teacher's assistant at Glen Hills Elementary. He told authorities he was at the trampoline park visiting family, but they later found out that wasn't the case. The guardian of the victim says she panicked when he told her what happened.
She said, well, there was an adult, and he asked me to sit down in front of him, and he wanted me to remove my socks. Started rubbing my feet. And then he started licking his toes.
Corey is charged with non-aggravated child molestation, and all new on News 12 at 6 o'clock, we're taking a closer look at what happened that day, his employment with the Richmond County School System, and how parents are feeling now.
Thanks for that update there, Terry. Taylor, certainly a strange situation happening at Urban Air, and unfortunate that that happened here locally.
And one that could really happen anywhere.
Absolutely.
A park, any business that attracts children. So a good reminder to parents, pay attention.
Yeah, and keep track of your children. Turning to weather now, we're taking a live update on the weekend forecast for you in just about 10 minutes.
All right, thanks for that, Riley. In just the last hour, we learned new details about the Grovetown home invasion that sent one suspect to the hospital. Everything unfolding in the 9,000 block of Battle Court a little before 4:30 a.m. Grovetown police say they got multiple calls of someone banging on doors of several homes in that area. Now, this is video of the scene just after gunfire was heard. After searching the scene, police found one suspect, Jordan Jackson, crying out for help after being shot. After tending to him, police say they learned from the homeowner that two men were caught on home security video trying to enter through the patio and rear window. After another search, they found Demon Livingston sitting in a car in the 6,000 block of Reynolds Way. After questioning him, they found out the pair were traveling together from Columbia, South Carolina. The first suspect, Jackson, is in the ICU. The second suspect, behind bars tonight.
And we are working to get their mug shots, and we'll update you as this story continues to develop. Well, the GBI confirms they are investigating the Waynesboro Police Department. They tell me they're investigating irregularities in training records within the department. The Waynesboro Police Department releasing this statement saying that they noticed some irregularities with a now former employee's training record. The department notified the State Training Council and GBI to look into the matter. We reached out to the GBI, Waynesboro Police Department, and Georgia Post to see who the employee was. The GBI won't release that information, and the police department and Post haven't got back to us. We did find Waynesboro Police Officer Gary Jenkins sent in a resignation letter on February 13th, which was on Monday. We reached out to Jenkins and have not heard back yet. Now, the police department says they demand integrity in all of their employees and take state training very seriously.
They say they will cooperate with all investigative authorities. South Carolina Attorney General Alan Wilson is joining a multi-state lawsuit against the Environmental Protection Agency to protect the state's sovereignty over water and land. Now, this comes after the newly published rule redefining waters of the United States, which expands federal authority over most any water in the country. In a news release, Wilson says, quoting here, "The waters of the United States rule is supposed to govern navigable waters, but this proposed rule goes so far that it could consider a farmer's drainage pond or a roadside ditch a navigable waterway. South Carolina and Georgia are two of 24 states who have their own interest in managing their land and water resources. Former South Carolina Governor Nikki Haley traveled to New Hampshire Thursday night for a campaign stop, her first since declaring herself a candidate for president. There she took time to deliver a subtle swipe to likely GOP rival and a current Florida governor, Ron DeSantis. Haley said Florida's so-called Don't Say Gay bill doesn't go far enough.
I'm sorry, I don't think that goes far enough. When I was in school, you didn't have sex ed until seventh grade. And even then, your parents had to sign whether you could take the class, and my dad wouldn't sign the thing. So I was the uncool kid in the back classroom that couldn't take sex ed. That's a decision for parents to make. That's not a decision for schools to make.
Haley is also expected to stop in Manchester later tonight. Keeping teachers in Georgia. New numbers say 82% of schools are short on educators.
And lawmakers are working fast to keep and attract teachers, and one of the proposals is higher pay. Abby Kasouris explains what's in the new package.
There are more than 100,000 teachers teaching more than 1.6 million students in our state every day. And right now, teachers say they're feeling burnt out. The state is trying to look for solutions. While the governor is pushing for pay raises, some other bills in the state house could address educators' top concerns.
Our educators have one goal, and that is the success of each and every one of our students.
Lisa Morgan, kindergarten teacher and the head of the Georgia Association of Educators, says the governor's proposal to raise teacher pay by $2,000 will help the teacher shortage problem. But a bill on the state house right now could address the number one reason teachers say they're leaving: mandated tests and teacher evaluations. House Bill 457 would remove the penalty system for teacher evaluations.
If a teacher gets two needs development within a five-year period, then they literally lose their career. And the thing that everyone needs to understand about the needs development in the evaluation process, that is not saying that the teacher is ineffective. That is saying that in some areas, the teacher is inconsistent in their practice.
There are several bills this session aimed at attracting and keeping educators here, and also support staff. Senate Bill 105 includes additional retirement benefits for bus drivers, cafeteria workers, and custodians.
When they retire, it's getting $290 a month for their pension, which is horrific. It is unconscionable.
And there's a bill out of Colorado getting Georgia's attention. It would create reciprocity between our state and several others, removing expensive licensing fees and long waiting periods. In DeKalb County, I'm Abby Kasouris.
A home goods retailer Tuesday morning filed for Chapter 11 bankruptcy protection for the second time in 3 years. Now the company is closing half of its stores. The Dallas company currently has almost 500 of them, down from 700 or so 3 years ago. And we did some digging for you. The Augusta location is open for now, but the Aiken and Charleston locations will be closing their doors.
If you have a sweet tooth, one iconic convenience store in Renz is expanding their pecan candy operations. Riley, are you a pecan or a pecan guy?
Pecan. I think everyone says pecan, pecan, Meredith. It's pecan pie, not pecan.
It's pecan pie.
It's
pecan
not.
Pie.
It's not. But I don't know.
Butter pecan ice cream, though. Page.
Pecan ice cream. I don't know. Tomato, tomato. We're looking at a beautiful into our Friday. We'll take a look at that weekend forecast for you just after break.
Dime and Temp, brought to you by Jamie Casino Injury Lawyers.
I'm a turn rely on Ramjet.
Breaking news, 6 people are dead and the gunman is in custody after a shooting spree in North Mississippi. One of the victims, a woman, was allegedly shot in her home. Another victim, a man, was shot inside a store.
The suspect, whose identity has not been released yet, was taken into custody without incident. The Mississippi Bureau of Investigation says they are assisting with the investigation, but we will give you more information when we can. But 6 killed in Mississippi in those shootings.
And turning to weather now, with degrees as we see a little bit cooler outlook tomorrow. Here's a look at the forecast for the next 7 days. We are getting back to some warmer weather as we head into early next week. 70s again Monday, and then 80s as we get into next Wednesday and Thursday.
All right, thank you, Riley. If you have ever passed through Wren's, you might have seen a big yellow sign with three words. The original pecan shop, or pecan shop. Well, that is Stuckey's, the iconic roadside chain that makes its own candy and pecan log rolls.
There you go. And business is booming, and now the owner wants to expand operations and bring in dozens of jobs to the area. Our Will Volk stopped by for a sweet treat and to ask why they chose to expand.
Stuckey's future is here.
What we're banking on and our strategic plan for the future is in manufacturing product that is made right here in Wren's, Georgia, in Jefferson County.
About 3 years ago, Stephanie Stuckey bought the company her grandfather created.
My grandfather sold Stuckey's in 1964, and what followed were decades of outside management. And frankly, the brand suffered greatly. We lost hundreds of stores.
After becoming CEO, she brought a new approach. Most of their focus now is on manufacturing Stuckey's signature products. They bought this plant in Wren's back in 2021.
And that's really been the secret to our comeback. The company has gone from six figures in debt to, we closed out last year, over $13 million in sales, and the future looks bright for us.
Stuckey says they've outgrown this facility. That's why they're expanding and adding at least 50 more jobs right here in Wren's.
We love the whole area in Augusta. My business partner lives in Augusta. There's a great workforce. There are people here who are committed to growing with us.
Stephanie Stuckey is leading her family's company into the future, and that future is in Wren's. In Wren's, Will Volk, on your side.
And Stuckey says that they moved their distribution center to Wren's last week.
They also have plans to move the company's original pecan shed to Wren's as a tourist attraction later this year. I'm going to put this on social media
to see. This word is going to tear us apart.
It isn't. Have you noticed that you haven't had to say it, and pecan has been for me to say?
I don't think that was on purpose, but it might be targeting. Who knows?
Coincidence, I think not.
Okay. Well, America's favorite pastime has been bringing people together for over 100 years. After the break, Dan tells us all about North Augusta's new softball league for seniors.
You're watching News 12 on your side.
National grade.
Good evening, everyone. In an effort to keep senior citizens both physically and socially active, the North Augusta Parks and Rec Department is starting an adult softball league for seniors. Every Tuesday, starting on March 21st, men and women from all over the CSRA, ages 50 and up, will be hitting the diamond over at Riverview Park to re-energize or discover their love for America's favorite pastime. This is going to help people out like Brenda Clark, who has been playing softball since she was 13 years old, and help her enjoy the competitive side of the game while also having fun and making some friends along the way.
I just love this group of guys. I mean, I've never played with guys that are more fun than this. You know, this, all of them, they're just fun. I can tell you that I push everything else aside for coming out here to play ball. You know, whatever I have to put on hold for a couple hours, that's what I do. I make this a priority.
You can learn more information about the new league from the North Augusta Parks and Rec Department, and I promise you, you are not going to want to miss the full story with this rowdy group of seniors. It will be all new on News 12 at 6 o'clock.
All right, thanks for that, Dan. Turning to entertainment news, Ant-Man is projected to make a splash in the box office.
America's favorite game is getting a movie. David Daniel has the scoop in your Hollywood Minute.
I'm the man who can give you the one thing you want.
The new Ant-Man movie is looking for a big opening weekend. The forecast website Box Office Pro predicts Ant-Man and the Wasp: Quantumania will be the first Ant-Man movie to debut with more than $100 million in North American ticket sales. It's the first Marvel movie to hit theaters since Black Panther: Wakanda Forever in November.
It's poetry, art, and math all working in magical synchronicities. It's the perfect game.
Tetris. I don't get it.
If you thought you knew Tetris, think again. Here's a look at the first trailer for the movie Tetris, a Cold War spy thriller starring Taron Egerton. He plays an entrepreneur obsessed with the game who travels to the Soviet Union to acquire the rights to what he's sure will be a sales blockbuster. Sorry. Tetris debuts on Apple TV Plus on March 31st. In Hollywood, I'm David Daniel.
Heading into the weekend, it's going to feel a little bit cooler out there Saturday, but the cold air does not stick around too long. Now look at that 7-day forecast just after break.
All right, some good news right here on Riverwatch Parkway. A new Crumble Cookies will open soon.
Oh boy.
Yep, at the Village of Riverwatch. Tiara, our producer, is very excited about
this. She went and took these pictures, I'm pretty sure. If I'm not mistaken, she went over there.
Details have not been revealed on when, but we will be there to let you know because Tiara will be first in line, won't she, Riley?
And she's going to order some back for us.
Yes, she will.
Hey, that's right down the street. That would be good stuff. And if you've never had them, definitely worth trying at least once. They're very, very good. Hey, we should have a very nice sunset out there over the next, say, 45 minutes. Once that sun gets a little bit lower into the sky, we have some exiting cloud cover. Beautiful afternoon on tap, just feeling a little bit cooler for us. We're currently at 53 degrees now here in Augusta. You factor in the wind, and that wind's still blowing anywhere from about 15 to 20 miles an hour across the region. As we head into our Saturday, it is going to be a cold start. We're going to wake up near freezing, but later into the afternoon, warm up into the mid to upper 50s. Luckily, a lot of sunshine is in our forecast tomorrow, so it should be a beautiful weekend, and it will start to feel a little bit warmer as we head into our Sunday. Here's a look over the next 3 days. So once again, warmer on Sunday with high temps back in the 60s. We'll start to see a few more clouds by the end of the weekend, but staying nice and rain-free. As we roll into next week, we could see a stray shower between Tuesday and Wednesday, but notice those temperatures. We're going to be back into the 80s by next Wednesday.
We are. It's going to be really nice, but those of us with allergies, we're going to be miserable for a little while. It's okay. It usually happens this time of year. News 12 at 6 o'clock is coming up next. Richard Rogers making his way into the studio as we speak.